Preparing Jobs That Fail to Satisfy, presented by Trevor McKenna, Wallace Jones, Monisha Mason, Dexter McCallahan, and myself, Kimberly Melendez. Learning goals. Dividing up work is the usual concept that companies use in order to improve efficiency. Through this division, specialization can lead to consequences that aren't necessarily positive. DreamFlow recently had multiple customer complaints that show the company's strong passion starting to slip and out of their hands. Unfortunately, DreamFlow has had this negative feedback due to the use of specialization in order to reduce costs. Major topic areas: job design and core functions of a human resource management, and it's related to specifications of context, methods, and relationships of jobs in order to satisfy technological and organizational requirements. Job satisfaction, the feeling of pleasure and achievement that you experience in your job when you know that your work is worth doing, or the degree to which your work gives you this feeling. Personality, relatively stable, consistent, and distinctive sets of mental and emotional characteristics that personal exhibits when alone or when interacting with people in his or her external environment. And emotional labor refers to the process by which workers are expected to manage their feelings in accordance to the organizational defined roles and effects.
So my name is Wallace Jones. I'll be talking about this scenario. So, the DreamFlow is a firm that specializes in large residential and commercial plumbing maintenance. Lee Rinaldo, regional manager for 2 years, used to work at a competing company, Lightning Plumber. She is being paid more at DreamFlow, but is not happy with the work environment. Lee Rinaldo believes employees aren't motivated to give great customer service like Lightner Plumber does. Through her research by giving out customer surveys, she found 60% of respondents were satisfied with the service and will use DreamFlow again. 40% said they won't use DreamFlow again, and 30% said they will use a competitor next time they have a plumbing problem. Scenario 2, breakdown of DreamFlow employees. 2,000 employees. Four basic job categories, which includes licensed plumbers, highest wages, plumber assistants. This allows DreamFlow to keep costs low versus competitors. Order processors and billing representatives. Structure is designed to keep costs as low as possible. Scenario 3. DreamFlow's business comes mostly from Yellow Pages and the internet. Customers either call to explain a plumbing problem or will fill out online requests for a plumber to come out to the residence. Through either method, company will decide severity of plumbing situation and then decide whether to send a licensed plumber or a plumber assistant.
Hello, Professor Lundy. My name is Trevor McKenna, and I'll be talking about the problem as of right now. Specialization can cut costs, but DreamFlow is worried about customer dissatisfaction. Through Lee's research, 25% of customer contacts led to no service because customers were confused by diagnosis, questions asked. The other 75% of calls led to customer service that still led to other problems. The most frequent complaints consisted of price of service and the time it took for either licensed plumber or assistant plumber to show up. If the licensed plumber or assistant plumber did show up on time, there were multiple occurrences where the company sent the wrong person for the job. Assistant plumber Jim Larson stated that when he arrives to a residence and the customer finds out that DreamFlow sent the wrong person, the customer gets upset that now they have to reschedule and take more time out of their busy schedule. There's also the occurrence when licensed plumbers go to a job that can be handled by an assistant plumber. The job is done fine, but then the customer has to pay the high premium for a licensed plumber. So this is a little breakdown of a little bit more of the problems that DreamFlow is occurring. The following chart shows the breakdown of the respondent satisfaction level across a number of categories on a scale from 1 to 5. As you can see, don't really have to go really vividly into it, But these say, I am satisfied with the work I am asked to do. I am satisfied with the work, my work conditions. I am satisfied with my interactions with coworkers. And I am satisfied with my interactions with my supervisor. As you can see, there is no number rating that is above 4.3. Most of them are in that range of around 3.5 or 2.5. So that's not really that good of ratings. So the proposed solution by Mrs. Lee, she's trying to figure this out. So the company's in deep trouble due to their shrinking revenues and their lack of cost savings they were supposed to achieve. Lee has proposed to give incentive to employees to improve their performance through cash rewards. So how she broke this down was, for every 20 calls successfully completed, workers get a small reward. When there are no complaints and the job is handled promptly, plumbers and plumber assistants will be given a moderate cash reward. If customer gives feedback of great satisfaction, a larger cash reward will be provided. Lee also proposes to have better hiring methods put in place, where standardized methods that are clear throughout all the branches. She believes this will allow DrainFlow to help managers identify recruits who can actually succeed in the job.
My name is Monisha Mason, and I'll be going over the three case questions. Case question number one, although it's clear employees are not especially satisfied with their work, do you think that is a reason for concern? Does research suggest satisfied workers are actually better at their jobs? Are there any behavioral outcomes associated with job satisfaction? With employees not satisfied with their work and work conditions, it is most definitely a concern. If workers are not satisfied, that means they are not motivated to succeed, and that will end up hurting the company in the short and long run. Continuous research has shown that satisfied workers are not only better at their jobs, but are more motivated to make the company successful. Other behavioral outcomes include trust between coworkers and an overall better positive facade in the workplace. Case question number two. Using job characteristics theory, explain why the present system of job design may be contributing to employee dissatisfaction. Describe some ways you could help employees feel more satisfied with their work by redesigning their jobs. In DrainFlow, the overall job design has too many workers handling difficult situations that can throw off the entire daily procedures. Through this job design, workers are becoming flustered because they keep making mistakes, and it is causing tension among coworkers. By having a set script on what exactly everyone should do and every decision that needs to be made in every situation will loosen the stress among coworkers and individual workers. Case question number three. Lee has somewhat vague idea of how to implement the cash reward system. Describe some of the specific ways you should make the reward system work better based on the case. With Lee creating such a vague cash reward system, it is essential that the reward system structure is put in writing and clear enough for workers to understand how the system works. You don't want to be Lee when coworkers start complaining about not getting a reward because they either feel the judgment was wrong or the reward shouldn't be based on someone else's performance.
So my name is Dexter Clenahan, and this is case question number four. And the question was, explain the advantages and the disadvantages of using financial incentives in a program of this nature. What, if any, potential problems might arise if people are given money for achieving customer satisfaction goals? What types of incentives might be considered? And the answer that we got for this question is, although that Lee has designed a reward that will help the morale of the workers, the reward needs a few tweaks. And the advantages of the reward type system includes worker motivation and competitive nature. And as for the disadvantages, Lee needs to make sure that through the reward spot, that there isn't an added stress or pressure between coworkers to achieve their tasks in order to receive cash rewards. The reward type system should strictly just give individuals a competitive nature to go above and beyond their expectations and to achieve their daily goals. Lee, he also might want to consider types of incentives besides cash, including travel, time off, or some type of clothing or some type of merchandise.
Okay.
So for case question 5, the question was, create a specific plan to assess whether the reward system is working. What are the dependent variables that should change if the system works? And how will you go about measuring the success? And the answer that we got is, in order to make sure that the reward system is efficiently and successfully working, it is essential to understand what dependent variables should change, and if the system is effective. These dependent variables include customer satisfaction, the correct plumber assistant making it to the correct house, and whether or not customers come back to DrainFlow for future plumbing needs. To measure these variables, it is important to keep tabs on each variable and to continuously monitor the positive and the negative outcomes. Case question. The question was, what types of hiring recommendations would you make to find people that are suited for these jobs, better suited for these jobs? And which big 5 personality traits would be useful for the customer service responsibilities and emotional labor? And for this question, as a group, our recommendations would include having specific qualities, certain qualifications, and distinct morals and ethics portrayed on the DrainFlow job applications. The main types focuses of the big 5 traits that DrainFlow should try to focus on are conscientiousness, openness, and agreeableness. Conscientiousness is the idea of a worker wishing to do what is right and especially to do one's work or duty well and thoroughly. Openness includes the tendency to appreciate ideas, to appreciate behaviors, values, and ideas. And last, agreeableness is the tendency to agree and go along with others rather than to assert one's own opinions and choices. And through these 3 traits, we believe that at DrainFlow that the customers' satisfaction should be good, and as well as the license and the assistant plumbers exuding positive emotion, labor that is seen helpful, kind, and productive to the consumer. And thanks for watching, and there you go.